Hello friends, welcome to the Padho India editorial discussions. In this channel, we will discuss the editorials from the Times of India, Hindustan Times, the Indian Express, the Hindu, the Economic Times, as and when they are relevant for the UPSC examination. The probable questions will be discussed and the handwritten notes of the editorials will be available on the Telegram channel free of cost. Today we have the who, what, why, when, where column in the Hindu, and the first for discussion is G.D. Agarwal, Save Ganga Crusader. Now, Mr. G.D. Agarwal was the Save Ganga Crusader from India and he had adopted the name Swami Gyan Swarup Sanand. He, on October 11, 10 days before, in this month only, he died on the 112th day of his fast. The discussion is because he had earlier been a professor in civil engineering department in IIT Kanpur, worked in a construction of Tehri Dam, and he is the first member secretary of CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board. Can see that he is very learned as well as has deep understanding both scientifically and spiritually about the Ganga river. Ecologically and technically he is equipped to check whether the standards are good or not of the construction. So while working as the engineer, he developed a viewpoint against the hydroelectric projects in the upper tracts of the rivers in the Himalayan ecosystem. So his achievements were, he, because of the pressure exerted by him, there was set up the National Ganga River Basin Authority. He was able to introduce the concept of ecological flow in planning of the hydroelectrical projects. Ecological flow is the minimum requirement of the water flow in the river during this process. He was, because of his protests, Bhagirathi was declared as an eco-sensitive zone. Later on, when he came to realize that only through scientific revolution or realization, he will not be able to bring in a revolution, or he could not make the masses aware. The need of the hour was to popularize the movement. So, he co-opted religion. This is a very important point. And he said that purely scientific, it will take too long. So, to popularize, he will make use of religious sentiments as well, because we know that India is a deeply religious society. His latest demands were the Ganga Act, legal standing to Ganga Brahma, Ganga Bhakti Parishad. Ganga Bhakti Parishad is a congregation of devotees, and he wanted the Ganga Bhakti Parishad to take all the decisions regarding the regeneration of the river Ganga. He wanted to ban dams in the upper tracts of the Himalayan rivers. So the two questions which can be framed because of this is, despite so many efforts by the government and despite so many protests, why is there no progress in the clean Ganga? There is also international awareness about cleaning the river Ganga. So why is the effort so minimal? Why is there no outcome? The second is, can there be no scientific reform carried out in India without bringing in religion? Because we can see that there were bhakti reforms as well when we wanted to bring in social reforms such as caste in the social religious reform movements era. In the bhakti movement also, caste was a major factor. Caste is a social phenomena, whereas we had the bhakti movement as well to overcome caste. So the question can be, Indian society cannot be developed without religious reform, critically analyze. Now the second editorial of the day is the lowdown of NCR's air quality. On this we have, in 2010 to 2018, there has been a 15% increase in the PM 2.5 level. PM2.5 is carcinogenic. It means that it can cause cancer. Transport is responsible of 40% of the pollution, and dust is 21.5. PM10 has grown 3 times the prescribed limit in the past week. Reasons are decreasing wind speed. This allows the dust particles and other particles to stay for a longer time. Changing in the direction of wind to northwest. This brings in pollution from the stubble burning in Punjab and Haryana. Increased traffic because of festive season, garbage dumping, waste burning, and construction activities. So, what are the bad effects of air pollution? It harms the skin, ear and nose, breathlessness, cough, fever, choking sensation, respiratory, nervous system, and cardiac risk increases. To solve the problem, we need proper and comprehensive steps in waste management, and we need to shift to cleaner fuels. Both of these need to be done simultaneously. We can have a holistic question on this based on asking you the reasons for so much pollution in NCR in particular. There has already been a question on why NCR or Delhi has more pollution than Mumbai or Kolkata. So this is a thing which needs to be considered. Moreover, we can also be asked the harmful effects of pollution and a policy. What are the steps or suggestions? So waste management and shifting cleaner fuels, we will need to go into the intricacies of both these points. The next in why, what, where, how in the Hindu is immigrants in Gujarat. In Sabarkantha village, a 14-month-old child was raped. And since then, the Gujarat Kshatriya Thakur Sena has declared that we will not tolerate any immigrants in the city. Before the rape also, the Gujarat CM had announced 80% jobs to be reserved for locals in any private entity, may it be Indian or an outside entity. So the immigrants or the migrant laborers are mostly focused in the construction sector. They are working as security guards, drivers, domestic workers, and in factories. They form about 35% of the labor force. The steps taken by the police to protect this labor force was they filed FIRs. They had provided security to migrant workers around their residential areas and the industrial complexes. So the future is uncertain because on one hand, the government is providing them with security. And on the other hand, 80% reservation is being given to locals. So we can see at present there are 35% people who are engaged in who are migrants and are in labor force. If the restriction will be of 80% locals, so what will be the fate of those 15% who will be there? So this leaves them in an uncertain future. Now the next is Dhaka's concern in the Rohingya shifting plan. Now the Rohingyas are concentrated in Kutupalong camp near the Cox's Bazar beaches in Dhaka, in Bangladesh. The proposal is to shift them to an island in the middle of violence, which is in the path of many violent storms. The problem is the Bangladeshis say that even though the Rohingyas are Muslims, but they are not Bengalis. So there is a need to conserve separate Bengali identity. India and China are building homes in their Rakhine province. Rakhine is a province in Myanmar where the Rohingyas are concentrated. But the Rohingyas are not going back. See, this is a fact that whenever the crisis is over, those who have received shelter, they need to return back. But Bangladesh is complaining that we cannot continue for much longer. They need to return. But they are not going. The living conditions in the current camps are the place was a wildlife sanctuary, particularly for elephants. So there was a lot of wildlife, leopards were there, there were threats. So the forests were cleared. There is a lot of ecological harm done to the place. And unorganized, overcrowded and unplanned slums have come up. And also the standard of life is very low. So there are 3 aspects. First is, will they return or not? And the second is, will they be getting justice to what the Myanmar military force has done towards them, and also what will be their final residence. The conflicting interests involved are the Rohingya population say that we want to go back, but we do not have a home there. Every property is destroyed. Justice is, will they be getting justice to what the excesses the police and the army have done towards them, and what will be their final residence? Who lit the fire? This is an editorial in the Indian Express. The author is critical of the role of media in politicizing the Sabarimala issue, even after the SC verdict. So this, in Sabarimala, we will always be talking about the injustice or equality towards women. But the extra point we have got here is role of media. They say that the author says that the media has overhyped the issue, and they say that the only opposition was from the family of the Thantri. Thantri is the head priest, and the Pandalam royal family. There was no other opposition. Even the BJP and the RSS backed it. All the other political parties backed it. This is written in the editorial. So still, it has not been able to be done because of the role of media. She says that the 24-hour or 24/7 media is responsible for spreading misawareness or false information is being spread out by the media, and which is supporting these two sections, the Thantri and the royal family. Now, the second editorial was related to Me Too. Me Too, get beyond, will the Me Too go beyond me? This talks of children forced into prostitution. The author has been working with an NGO. She explains her experiences. So this gives us another dimension of the Me Too revolution right now, which says that, is it only an elitist concept? Is it only elite? Are only those persons who are working in MNCs or are actors or rich? Can only they speak, or will only they speak? What about those children or women who are under forced to go under sexual exploitation and prostitution? Is it only an elitist concept? So this is an additional dimension. This is written by Meghna Desai in the Indian Express, The Me Too Revolution. He says that it began with the Nirbhaya case. She was an ordinary woman with aspirations to do better for herself and her family, so many could relate with her. The Me Too is about equality and security in the work life of a woman. Advantage of social media is that there are less chances of threatening the victim. There is inability of the parliament, because when there is a dominant group for caste, they are able to get representation. When religion, they are able to get representation, because there are political parties based on religion, caste. But women are not represented, even though they form almost 50% of the population. They are not even able to get 33% of the reservation. They say, if SCs and STs are around 24% or 25% of the population, inka reservation bhi isi ke proportion mein hota hai. But women ka to 33% bhi nahi hai. What he is trying to say is, even though women form about 50%, their representation in parliament is 11.2%, and they are struggling to get reservation for even 33%, which is not at par. He says that yes, the Me Too is a revolution, but rule of law must also be taken care of, and every person is innocent until proven guilty. This is a very important article in the Hindustan Times. Guardians of our Ecological Galaxy by Ramchandra Guha. In his statements, may say there are straightaway questions asked in the mains. He has, in a way, discussed the role of foreigners, especially women, foreigner women, in the ecological movements in India. He discusses the case of Meera Behen. She was the aide of Mahatma Gandhi. Real name is Madeline Slade, daughter of a British admiral. British army mein admiral the, British Indian army, navy mein honge. So she lived in the Gadwal area after she left the Gandhi ashram. In Rishikesh, Amar Chitra Katha mein inka varnan hai. She has been spoken about in the Amar Chitra Katha. She has criticized the short-sighted policies of development after independence. सरला बहन इन द कुमाऊ रीजन, कैथरीन मेरी हिलमैन, लक्ष्मी आश्रम इन्होंने बनाया कसौनी में। शी ट्रेन्ड सुंदरलाल बहुगुणा, विमला बहुगुणा, चंदी प्रसाद भट्ट एंड राधा भट्ट। दीज फॉलोअर्स फर्दर टुक द चिपको मूवमेंट, दे प्रोटेस्टेड अगेंस्ट कमर्शियल फॉरेस्ट्री, लार्ज डैम्स, ओपन कास्ट माइंस, कंस्ट्रक्टिव प्रोग्राम्स इन रिफॉरेस्टेशन एंड वाटर कंजर्वेशन। फेब्रवरी 2011 में निगमानंद स्वामी, हु वॉज अ यंग सेंट, ही पास्ड अवे इन द थर्ड मंथ ऑफ हिज फास्ट। ही सेज, रामचंद्र गुहा सेज दैट डॉक्टर मनमोहन सिंह वॉज अनमूव्ड बाय इट एंड नाउ स्वामी सानंद हैज पास्ड अवे, हु कुड प्रोवाइड साइंटिफिक रैशनैलिटी एंड स्पिरिचुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द प्रोसेस। सो एंड दिस टाइम ऑल्सो द प्राइम मिनिस्टर कुड ओनली शो हिपोक्रेसी, दिस इज वॉट द ऑथर सेज। सो इसमें सवाल ये आ सकता है, डिस्कस द रोल ऑफ फॉरनर्स, फॉरनर्स या फिर वुमेन, फॉरनर वुमेन इन इकोलॉजिकल मूवमेंट्स इन इंडिया। फिर दूसरा, व्हाट हाउ हैव दे इवॉल्व्ड एंड द रिस्पॉन्स, डिस्कस या डिस्कस द रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट या क्रिटिकली एनालाइज द एप्रिसिएशन गिवन टू द पर्सन इन्वॉल्व इन इकोलॉजिकल मूवमेंट्स बाय द गवर्नमेंट।